Hello, welcome to SS Unitech. Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we are going to discuss about the sort transformation, and this is very useful transformation while you are going to use the merge statement and merge join. So what is sort transformation? So sort transformation is used to sort source data in either ascending or descending order, which is very similar to order by statement in T-SQL command. Merge transformation and merge join transformation need data to be sorted before using them. So if you are getting the data from the source which is not in sorted, so by using sort transformation we can sort the data, and it's a fully blocking transformation. So we need to avoid this transformation while using the big table, and it's also used to remove the duplicate records from the source data. It only look for the source key column value. If it found duplicates, then remove any of them and get unique values. Like if we have four columns in our table, like ID, name, date of birth and gender, and we are going to sort on the behalf of ID, and in ID column we have the duplicate record and rest of the column we don't have the duplicate values, so it will look only ID column. And if duplicate value will be found, then one row will be deleted and unique value will be available. So we have a SQL Server table for our testing purpose. So let's have a look of that table. So this is our table with the name of sort. As we can see, it has only one column, which is name, and it contains the values. So in our first row, in our last row, we can see it seems to be duplicate. So one value should be deleted. So how we can achieve this? Let's move to SSDT to create our package. So right click on this and create a new package, and then I wanna rename with sort. Then we need to drag and drop data flow task, double click on this, and here we need to select our source. So our source is OLEDB source, so we can drag and drop OLEDB source, and then we need to configure. Here we need to select our connection manager, click on new. As we have already made the connection, so I am going to use that one. Click on OK. Here we need to select the table. So our table is sort. As we can see, this is our table. Go to on columns. We have only one column, which is name. So we are OK with it. Click on OK. So we have done our source part. Now I am going to use the sort transformation. So this is our sort transformation. We can drag and drop this and connect with the source. Now we need to click on sort. Once we click on sort, then we can see available input columns. So we can select our column and we want to order by with that column in ascending order or descending order. According to our requirement, we can set the sort type. Here we have option for remove rows with the duplicate sort values. Once we select this checkbox, then our duplicate value will be removed. Now click on OK. As we can see in our input, we have a duplicate value and that value will be removed. I am not going to load this data into any destination. I am going to display this data by using multicast. So we can drag and drop this multicast. Then we can connect with sort. Now we can enable our data viewer. Then we can execute our package. So here we can see 1, 2, 3 we are getting only once. So duplicate value has been removed. Next is sorting with the string data. SQL Server sort and SSIS sort treats as a differently, because SQL Server uses the case insensitive and SSIS uses the case sensitive. So as we can see in our SSIS sort and in our SQL Server sort. So in our first row, we have the same data. In our second row and third row, we are getting the same data. In our fifth row and in our sixth row, so we have the different values in case of SSIS sort and SQL Server sort. Let's have a look in SSDT and SQL Server. So here, as we can execute our package. Now I am going to copy this data, so we can open Excel and paste that data. Now go to SQL Server and I am going to use order by 1 and copy this data and paste that data. So as we have removed the duplicate value, so we can delete our 1, 2, 3, and here we can see. So this is our SSIS sort and this is our SQL Server sort. So we are getting the different values in case of 4th row, 5th row, in case of 7th row, 8th and 9th row. because SQL Server uses case insensitive and SSIS uses case sensitive. So how we can remove this different behavior? So once we use the case sensitive in our SQL Server, then that will be removed. So go to our SQL Server and paste that query. Here we can execute and copy the data and go to on Excel. Now I am going to paste that data and delete one row. As you can see, in our SSIS sort and SQL Server sort, both are treated as a similar. So you need to remember while using sorting with the string data types. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Thank you so much.